this is Michael, KB9VBR, your host for Ham Radio Q&A. I'm on a mission to inspire and educate the amateur radio community, so you can help us out by pressing that like button, hitting subscribe, and also checking us out on Patreon. Patrons help keep the mission alive, and it's greatly appreciated. Well, today, this is a beautiful sunny day, and it's a perfect time to work on the solar project for my camping trailer. We've got all of the parts assembled here, so hopefully we can get everything done today, but basically this project is kind of broken down into three phases or segments. So first off, we're going to have to install the panel, and this is a 180-watt mono-crystalline solar panel. It's going to be mounted on this aluminum strut, and then the strut will go onto the roof rack of the trailer here behind the awning. Next, after we get that done, we're going to have to run some cable. A wire will come down the front, and then underneath, we'll install one of these SAE connectors. It's a waterproof type connector, and from there, cable will go into the cabin and then to the galley, where we will be installing the charge controller. And this is the DIY Solar For You Sol 20 amp MPPT charge controller. I did a video on this taking a look at the controller itself, so you might want to check out the link for that if you were interested in this device. I got it prepped here for the install project, so we've got the battery cable and also the panel cable already in place. This ferrite on the end of the panel cable will help reduce any RFI emissions from the controller. I want something that's very RFI quiet, and this is one of the features and benefits of this controller is that it'll work quite well for amateur radio applications, and that's part of the reason why we're doing this project today. Then this will be installed in the galley, and then once everything is hooked up, hopefully we'll be making some power. So stick around as we put together the solar project on this beautiful sunny day. I think I'm gonna have to do a little bit of modification here. We're gonna drill some extra holes, so I'm gonna put an extra bracket. This is the front of the panel, because there's where the plugs are. I'm gonna put an extra one right here in the front, just to give it extra stability. And then I think I'm also gonna have to re-drill the hole on this one and move it back just enough so we don't interfere with where the U-bolts are going to come through. And I think, and I may have to, because things aren't quite lining up here, so I may have to drill some extra holes into the Z-brackets so that we get everything to line up on the panel. So I guess this is probably about a good enough time as any to take a little bit of a break, because I've run out of parts. I gotta run to the hardware store, get a few more of these stainless fender washers, because I decided to put an extra Z bracket in place. I'm a couple short, so get a couple more of those. I think I'm gonna put some Loctite on these nuts. there's a lock washer on there along with standard washers, but we'll put some Loctite on those too. The rest of these are all Nylock, so I'm not really worried about those. I think those will be fine, but otherwise I think it's coming along nicely. So we get some extra parts and we'll get this panel on the roof of the trailer. We've got the solar panel mounted on the roof of the trailer, and this process was probably a little bit more involved than what I was expecting, but overall I think it turned out pretty well. We are using a couple of aluminum unistruts as our main support, and this thing feels pretty sturdy. I'm not really concerned about it coming off in the wind. And then these Z-clips, I had 2 4-packs of clips, so I added a couple extra clips onto the front side of the panel just to give it a little bit more stability on the leading edge. And had to re-drill a couple of holes just to make everything kind of line up. But other than that, it went on nice, and it's a good, solid, stable platform. I think this will work really well. Now, one thing to really be careful of when you're doing a solar project is the polarity of your cables. You'll notice that both of these cables coming off the solar panel are black. They do have different connectors on them, these MC4 weatherproof connectors. So the female one and a male one. And also, the manufacturer of the panel put little stickers on here so you know which one is the positive and which one is the negative. And make sure that you trace back so that positive is positive, negative is negative. You don't want to leave anything to chance of hooking up your panel backwards or reversing the polarity. Now, to get this cable inside the trailer, I initially wanted to put a port in this gap right here between the utility box and the trailer itself, but all of the ports that I found online were just way too thick, and this gap is pretty small, so it was kind of difficult to find something that was going to work. So my alternate route is to put this underneath. And we'll use an adapter here. This adapter's got MC4 connectors on one end, and it's got an SAE automotive style connector on the other end. And then we'll come underneath and plug it in here. And I think this is gonna have the added benefit of now I can get underneath the trailer and unplug the panel if I ever need to. I can put a Y cable on here and add a second panel easily from the underneath of the trailer. I think it's gonna work really well. Now, other problem I have is I initially wanted to drill a hole, into this steel frame, but I don't think I'm gonna do that. But instead, this box is sitting on top of sort of expanded steel mesh, and I think I'll remove this box and kind of make a little channel for this to thread this cable through, and we'll clean it up with some grommets and whatnot. I don't think that's not going to happen today. I think today we're just going to kind of come in around underneath here and get the get the cable connected. But before we really start taking off with this thing, we'll get I'll get that cable properly routed underneath between the channel here. So at this stage, I'm gonna be putting the solar charge controller down in the galley here. The trailer has a little metal mounting plate where the power distribution box is located. I'm gonna have to drill a few holes right here because nothing lines up with the controller. So we'll mount the controller to this plate and then we'll wire it. It's going to wire directly to the battery, and then the battery will go to the power distribution, and then et cetera, et cetera. So we'll have to modify this a little bit. So I think we're pretty close to the moment of truth. I got my battery here. We're gonna get the battery connected. We'll connect the battery first, and then do the make sure everything's working with the controller, and then we can connect the panels and see what happens. We have the battery connected, but not the panel. So that all looks normal. And we have success. Oh, let's see, this project took me about 6 hours from start to finish. It's about 6 o'clock here. So. Not much sunlight left for the panels to catch, but it's working. Right now my battery's fully charged. It shows over 14 volts on the meter, and the charge controller won't kick in until the floating voltage of the battery drops down below 13.5 volts. So I could probably put a load on the battery and that would get things going, but otherwise it's showing what the controller's showing is open circuit on the panel at approximately 21.6 volts, 22 volts, which is normal for this panel. And it's the little meters or the little displays going through its cycle, so it's telling me the battery is in essence full. And it's waiting for the voltage to drop down so the controller can kick in and do its job. But otherwise, pretty rewarding project. I had a lot of fun putting this together. It's a lot of bits and pieces, but just kind of thought it through logically, and everything sort of came together. So I'm really excited. Now that we've got full-time solar power on this trailer, we're going to put in the galley here, we'll stick an electric refrigerator so I don't have to buy ice anymore. We'll be off-grid, totally off-grid camping. So it's a great project. I'm really excited. And the DIY Solar For You controller seems to be, it's doing its job.
So the next day, I decided to do a little test, and I plugged in our 12-volt electric blanket into the trailer to put a load on the battery, and the solar controller kicked in, started charging the battery, and it is, sun is just coming up over the top of the house. It's a partly cloudy day, and we're getting, from the panel, 52 watts, 19.6 volts, batteries at 13.6 volts, 3.72 amps, output of 51 watts, 72.8 is the board temperature. So it's working, it's grabbing sunlight and making energy.
And with that, thanks for watching. If you have any questions or comments about this video, about questions about solar, the charge controller, or anything like that, be glad to answer them. Leave them down below. I'll filter through the questions and comments, and who knows, maybe they'll end up on our next Your Questions Answered live stream. But for more articles and information, be sure to check out my blog and my website with antennas for sale at www.jpol-antenna.com. Support of this channel drives the production of future videos, so you can do a few things for me. You can hit the like button, you can subscribe to the channel. Subscribing is the best way to be notified when a future video is released. And you also can check us out on Patreon. Patrons help keep the mission alive over here, and so their support is really appreciated. And with that, I'm Michael, keep an eye on VBR, have a great day, and 73.